Hey guys, it's Alex, and today I'm here with a quick unhaul. I've been going through my shelves some, and I always just keep a stack of books that I'm planning on getting rid of whenever I make my next trip to the little free library. And I've just hit 10 books, so I wanted to show you guys the 10 books I'll be getting rid of and hopefully taking to a little free library very soon. The first is Kathy Reich's 206 Bones. This is the 12th book in the Temperance Brennan series. I gave this one star. I read it in September, so very recently. I really hated this book, like in all ways, shape, and form. I think this was like probably a particularly bad place to start in the series, but even then, I was just not a fan. This one was a miss for me in like every possible way. Then I have What Alice Forgot by Leanne Moriarty. I actually do like Leanne Moriarty, but her books tend to be like one-time entertaining reads for me, and then I never want to pick them up again. They're just fun for like once, but they're not books that I'm really particularly attached to. I do have two of her books on my shelf, one that I've read, Big Little Lies, and enjoyed and plan to keep, and then another that I haven't yet read, but I don't remember liking this one that much. I think the story itself was fine, but I just mostly remember being annoyed at the ending because there were basically two ways this book could end, and it ended one way, and I was fine with that. And then there was an epilogue where it ended the other way, and it just kind of pissed me off because it was like she was trying to please all the readers. Like, she was like, okay, some readers are gonna want this ending, and other readers are gonna want that ending. So I'll just give them both instead of having to choose one. And that just annoyed me. I can't remember if I gave this book 2 or 3 stars, but like I said, I remember it being fine and entertaining. It just, yeah, the ending rubbed me the wrong way, and I just don't need to keep it. Then I have The Girls Are Gone by Michael Broadcorb and Alison Mann. I actually kind of wanted to keep this book, and I'm kind of sad that I'm getting rid of it because this was the first book that was given to me for review. Like, specifically given to me. I was asked if I wanted to read this book, and it sounded good, so I said yes, and then I gave it 2 stars. I have a very long review on this, but basically, I didn't trust the authors. They were very, very biased, and more biased than I would expect in a book like this, and it very much rubbed me the wrong way, and I gave it 2 stars, so like, I shouldn't just keep it for sentimental reasons, so I'm getting rid of it, and maybe someone else will like it. Like, maybe I'll give it to the little free library, and someone will pick it up and be like, wow, this is amazing, and then it will have done something good in being sent to me, hopefully, but not for me, and I don't know. It's sad that I'm getting rid of the first book I was ever sent for review, but also, like, it was not for me. Then I have Zipped by Laura and Tom McNeil. This is a YA contemporary that I've had on my shelf for a very, very long time. I think this was one of those books that just, like, my father was given at some point and he passed it along to me. I do remember that I read it, but I remember absolutely nothing about it. I think I remember feeling kind of mediocre after reading it. Like, okay, I read that. It was a book. But, like, literally nothing else. And I looked at the summary, and the summary didn't look like something I'd ever reread, so pass it along and maybe some kid will like it. Then I have Water for Elephants by Sarah Gruen. I'm only getting rid of this because I found a better copy. This is a very beat up mass market paperback with the movie tie-in cover, and I'm not a fan, but also I do want to read this book, so I picked it up. But then I found a much prettier, it was a trade paperback with like the original cover. It's in good condition, so I picked that up instead. And maybe someone else who doesn't have a pretty copy will appreciate this a little more than me. The Hardy Boys Case Files number 4, The Lazarus Plot. I have a duplicate of this one as well. I couldn't remember which ones I owned when I went to the thrift store, and they had a couple, so I got everything they had, and then this one was a duplicate, which is fine. It cost like less than $1, so someone else will appreciate this. I'm trying to collect all of these books. I only have a couple, but when I was a kid, these were just like the most melodramatic, ridiculous Hardy Boys plots, and I couldn't read them all because I didn't have them and they weren't at my library, but they're also the kind of books that have to be read in order. And I think at some point, like, Isla died in these books, and I was like, people die in Hardy Boys, and I always wanted to, like, read them all. So, yeah, this is going, but, like, I love these. And then we have The Next Accident by Lisa Gardner, which I talked about in my last haul video. This is not a bad book. I can't remember if I gave it 2 or 3 stars, honestly, but I really enjoy Lisa Gardner. This I just accidentally bought because I thought I hadn't read it, and then, like, 10 minutes after I bought it, I was like, oh no, I actually did read it. So I will just be passing it along, and hopefully someone else can find this and enjoy it, because I do like Lisa Gardner, but most of her books are just, like, one-time reads for me, and I don't need to re-experience them. And then we have Prisoner of Night and Fog by Anne Blankman. I read this last year, and I originally planned on keeping it, but The further I get from it, the less I'm interested in it. This is a YA historical fiction novel set in Nazi Germany about a girl who is Hitler's niece. Not literally his niece, but he is basically like an uncle to her. He was close friends with her father, and she falls in love with a Jewish boy, and there is drama and romance, and I gave it 3 stars. Like, it was fun. I just remember that it felt like Anne Blankman tried to cover difficult topics that she didn't really handle the best possible way. And I just remember thinking that, like, it would have been so much more fun. Like, this would have been pure fun entertainment if she hadn't tried to deal with difficult subjects. Like, if she just made this fun, I would have maybe given it 4 stars, but I don't know. Like, I'm not gonna reread it, and like, the longer it sits on my shelf, the more I think that I really don't need to own it, and hopefully someone else will really love it. And then we have Behind Closed Doors by B.A. Paris, which was a BookTube darling a couple years back, like in 2017, I think, when this came out. Everyone was talking about this book, and everyone loved it. It's an adult thriller, and I went in with the wrong expectations. I thought it was going to be about an abusive relationship, and it kind of was, but not really. And I don't know how to explain it without spoiling it, because it's one of those books that, like, you can't really know anything going in. But also, like, I don't want anyone to go in with the wrong expectations like I did, because I was expecting it to be about a typical abusive relationship where the two people are in love, but one of them is abusing the other. And it's about, like, getting up the courage to leave and, like, escaping them or, like, whatever, in a thriller kind of way, of course, because this is a thriller. And it wasn't. And, like, it is about an abusive relationship, but it's not. And that's, like, as much as I can say without spoiling it. But I had the wrong expectations for it, and the expectations ruined it, and that makes me sad, because it wasn't the book's fault. Like, I gave it 3 stars, but I don't think I would have liked the book itself had I not had the wrong expectations. Like, it probably still would have been 3 stars, but yeah, I don't know. Like, I'm just rambling, because like, I can't say, like, what I actually think, because it's a spoiler. But yeah, I don't know. I didn't think it was bad. It was just kind of like, meh, not for me. The final book is The Deep End of the Ocean by Jacqueline Michard. This is an adult contemporary about a woman whose son has been kidnapped. It was published in the 90s, I think. I just kind of randomly picked it up at a thrift shop because I liked the cover and it sounded fascinating. Like, I love books that deal with, like, parents whose children have gone missing. I love missing persons cases. End of the day, whether it's like a contemporary or a thriller or whatever. This is definitely not a thriller, it's a drama novel, but it was just kind of like mediocre, you know? I think I gave it 3 stars. I mostly found like the mother really annoying and I didn't like the writing super much, I don't think. I don't know. It was fine, and it was fine enough that I left it on my shelf for a while. I read it back in like January or December, but at the end of the day, like, I don't need to own this book. I'm never gonna read it again, and I really haven't thought about it since the last time I read it. So I'm sure someone else will love this, because I do think this is the kind of book where I wasn't the right person for it, but I can see people really loving it, even if I didn't think it was like the greatest thing. But I don't know, it wasn't like terrible, it just wasn't very good for me. I could try to sell these books, but honestly, I would probably get like $2 for all of them, maybe, at my local used bookstore. So I'm just gonna take them to a little free library, and hopefully that little free library will have something I like. Let me know down below if you've read any of these, what you thought of them, if you liked them, where I didn't. And as always, thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see y'all again soon.